All right, y'all. Earlier, of course, we were talking about Donald Trump and his constant back and forth. So he's been going after everybody. So, you know, now he mad at Marshawn Lynch. Now he say he should be suspended from the NFL for sitting for the national anthem in Mexico City and standing up for the Mexican national anthem. He's gone after Colin Kaepernick, other NFL players, the whole drama with the Ball family, and I ain't talking about that nonsense because it's utterly ridiculous.
No,
two narcissistic people ain't wasting my time. Yeah. But I want to deal with this on our panel here because here's the deal. It's the reality. Mm-hmm. Donald Trump don't clap back on white folks.
No, he doesn't.
What made you think he would?
He's been blasted. Yeah. No. He's been blasted by Greg Popovich.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Steve Kerr has blasted him.
Said nothing.
Eminem
lit him up. Oh, he ain't said nothing about these white folks.
Said nothing.
But don't be a black player. Mm-hmm. Now all of a sudden he got lots to say.
He can't even be a black commentator because Jemele Hill got it too.
Yeah. Or a black congressperson.
Yeah.
But Steve Bannon made that excellent point where he said, when the conversation turns to race, we win. He's playing to his base. He's playing to the folks that love him and think he's their petty president. And they love to see him, quote unquote, clap back at these players.
Because he ain't gonna say nothing to white folks because that is his base.
And
he's perceived as, oh yeah, put them in their place.
Absolutely.
Right. It plays to the Breitbart-esque narrative of the ungrateful Negro.
Right.
You know, we give you all these opportunities. I save your kids.
Right.
You know,
yeah.
You're playing football when, you know, some other folk don't got opportunity to eat. You know, and you dare take a meal or you dare question something that we do. Mm-hmm. You know, it plays into that Breitbart-esque narrative, and I don't think he's going to slow it down anytime soon.
No.
But Marshawn Lynch's mom clapped back.
Oh, yeah.
I saw that.
Oh, my God. It made my life.
That was,
you know, she was like, well, you don't own an NFL team because why? They wouldn't let you.
Right.
Yep.
Loved
clap
it.
Back.
But I think, you know, but the bigger thing is this, you know, it's just extremely concerning. You know, one, his quotes for, you know, wanting to clap back at African Americans in general. I mean,
absolutely.
Whether it's a member of Congress or a commentator or pretty much any accomplished African American at this point, Roland, you're probably next on the list.
Right.
But I think what's concerning. What's concerning?
I want him to come for you.
The words of Cynthia and Tina. I wish a. What?
It's daytime TV.
Early in the morning.
But the thing is this.
That's not gonna happen.
Hey, Don, that wouldn't be wise. That wouldn't be wise.
But the thing is this: every moment he spent on Marshawn Lynch, every moment he spent on Colin Kaepernick, every moment he spent on LeVar Ball, is a moment we're not focused on Syria. It's a moment we're not focused on North Korea. It's a moment that we're still dealing with decapitated cities. It's a moment that we're not dealing with infrastructure in this country.
Or Russia.
It's a moment we're not dealing. Russia. It's a moment we're not dealing with spurred growth.
It's the classic collection.
Yeah, but that's why. You see, here's the piece. 2004. Howard Dean said, Republicans target, Republicans target broke white folks with God-gaze guns.
Yes.
In 2016, Donald Trump targeted them with anti-immigrants, targeted them with black folks.
Right.
He's pushing racial buttons.
Yes.
That's what he's doing. It's just understand. So again, all these people last night, they're like, oh my God, Roland, you see LeVar Bell on CNN, LeVar Ball on CNN? No. Mm-hmm. One, I don't watch CNN.
Right.
I don't. Two, I was watching a TV show last night and reading a book. I wasn't interested in listening to LeVar Ball talk about that because I'm not getting caught up in it. And I said it. I ain't spending a second on that nonsense.
Right.
And so this segment is just dealing with the overarching issue of Donald Trump has no issue targeting black people because what he is doing is, Tiffany, he is speaking to his base, hey y'all, I'm putting them in their place for y'all.
And let's be clear about who his base is so we can get specific and we can point to the people who put this man in office. White women and white men, un-college educated graduates. And when you talk about white women, not only do we have all these allegations happening.
No.
And he's not responding.
Tiffany, don't leave it at uneducated. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And educated
He's also, because a lot of them, he won college-educated white folks.
Yeah. Yeah.
See, a lot of them voted for him as well. And see, that's the mistake I think
they
we made.
Did.
Because these are the very poor folks who also don't mind him putting folks in place.
Right.
Absolutely not. They're also the same folks who showed up with tiki torches to Charlottesville. So when we talk about strategic racism, Roland, his political plan to, there are 10 countries right now on the temporary service protection we were talking about earlier, and pushing them out, making sure that he pushes out Latinos, making sure that he's pushing out the Muslims, making sure that he's pushing out all these people. It is strategic racism to make America great again for his white people.
So all I'm saying, folks,
so he's not going to attack them.
So folks, when y'all see these tweets, I'm just letting y'all know, understand what's going on, understand the purpose, understand why he's doing it. But let me be real clear, Donald Trump, come at me. Oh, I'm telling you right now.
I'm Russell, can't say it from now.
I'm telling you right now. I'm telling you right now.
Diamond silk,
I'm telling you right now.
I'm with you.
I just want him
ain't gonna end well.
I want him to like see, on accident.
I ain't gonna stop. Uh-oh. I'm not gonna stop.
Lord. I really want him to
hashtag
do that.
We tried to tell you.
We're gonna learn today.
We're gonna learn.
Weekdays on TV One.
I will never lie to you.
Oh my God.
Roland Martin.
He doesn't want to talk to us. He wants to ignore us.
Uncensored.
Hell no.
No.
That ain't gonna cut it, boo.
Unapologetic.
No, that is fundamentally false. You are wrong.
Unfiltered.
He wants an America where we all look alike. He ain't talking about black people.
Unrelenting.
You better go work out, because you got a fight on your hands.
News One Now with Roland Martin, weekdays at 7 a.m. on TV One.